Hey everybody, and welcome back to Maximalist Workshop. I want to start by saying that this is not a review of the Sovol SV08. I do plan to make one once I have more time to take footage, but I really want to be able to take these machines apart and mess with the macros and firmware before I can give a really good review. It's important to me not to just know how the machine will run out of the box, but also what the community can do with it, what third parties start to do with it, and really what this machine can do once it's been put through its paces, and I think that takes a little bit of time. That said, I wanted to follow up on a video I made recently because I was testing out the SV08 and I ran into an issue that I had never seen before from a brand new machine. So in this video I wanted to talk about three things. First, what the problem was. Second, what we can do about it in the short term. And third, where we go from here, because I think Sovol may need to make some changes to either their design or their manufacturing practices to fix this, so that people don't keep running into it, so that they don't have to keep replacing beds. So let's get started. Number one, what's the problem? In my last video, I showed how my basically brand new Sovol SV08 decided to destroy itself during an otherwise completely normal print. After that, it had suddenly lost the ability to auto-home, and it would just crash into the bed like this. At first, like many of you, I thought that this was an issue with the leveling probe right here inside the printhead that is meant to sense the bed during homing and during bed leveling so that the printer knows where the bed is. I tried using the standard bed that came with the machine, although I had been printing on the smooth bed that I was using that got damaged. But whatever I would do, it wouldn't sense any of the bed plates that I had on hand during normal leveling. So the first thing I did was literally pick up the plate and press it against the nozzle. As you can see, I ran a query for the nozzle to check to see if it was triggered over and over. Each time it said open, and on the Sovol SV08, open means that the bed is not being detected. No matter what I did, I would keep putting it in different positions and I would keep getting the same result. Open, 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 open. But then I pressed it directly against the probe itself and it triggered. And that told me that the probe wasn't completely dead. So there was more work to do here. I went ahead and pulled off the shroud. With the SV08, the shroud is incredibly easy to take off. It's very similar in design to the Bamboo Lab printhead shroud, where it's connected by a magnet, so all you have to do is pull it off and then unplug a wire. Super convenient, really great for maintenance. Thank you so much, Sovol, for doing that. And once you get the shroud off, you'll see that there's a little LED light, and as long as that light is on, that means that the probe is not yet triggered. So what I went ahead and did is I pressed the plate directly against the nozzle and I thought it would trigger, but it didn't. So I moved the plate around a little. And this is where I realized what the problem was. Some of you eagle-eyed viewers might see it already, but let me explain. The Sovol SV08 uses a nozzle that is designed to basically be press fit together. The nozzle itself, as you can see from this picture, is basically that entire section that's below, that's at the heat break and below, is all one part. It is very similar in design to the original Bamboo Lab nozzle. You can see it more clearly here. The nozzle itself is not screwed in like on some 3D printers. They are pressed in. And to the extent that they're pressed in, that means that, well, they can also be pressed out. Ideally, it's just not supposed to happen. On my nozzle, this is what it looked like. On the right is a spare nozzle that Sovol provided with the machine, and on the left is the nozzle that came pre-installed on the machine. Basically, the filament, somehow, maybe it's because of heat expansion causing the different parts to expand at different rates, or because the parts weren't fit together right in the first place. In any case, margin for error with respect to Z offset and making sure that the nozzle is close enough to the bed without being too far away is quite small. It's tenths or hundredths of a millimeter, and in order to print properly, the nozzle has to really not move anywhere from calibration to calibration, and if it does, you need to be able to account for it. Here, it's getting pressed out so fast that, of course, I don't have a chance to notice it. And it isn't something that I'm able to then account for. The machine can't account for it because the inductive probe doesn't know any better. So this is just an issue that can't really be caught unless you're checking the nozzle every single time, which for those of you who print often, like myself, is just not feasible. And if this is something that's happening between prints, then it's almost certainly something that's happening during prints. The vibrations from high-speed printing are probably helping to force the nozzle out. But we'll get back to that. For now, let's talk about the short-term solution. This is an easy fix, right? Because, okay, the nozzle fell apart. Put on a new nozzle. Let's do that. Taking off the nozzle on an SV08 is super easy. All you have to do is unscrew the front and the back. You don't even need to heat the machine up. You can just pull it out cold if you have unloaded the filament. Once you get those screws removed, you can go ahead and take out the hot end. The hot end should come free pretty easily. There are two cables connecting the hot end to the PCB on the print head. One is for the heater, the other one is for the thermistor. Those should also come off pretty easily. However, there is a zip tie that you'll have to clip the first time. I didn't put a new one on after I had removed it, but you might want to. Totally your preference, in my opinion. Next, remove the clip that's holding the old hot end together. Remove the heater, remove the thermistor. Go ahead and add those onto the new hot end in the places where they were on the old one. Assemble the new hot end with the heater and thermistor from the old one. Clip everything together with the clip, making sure to put some of that thermal goo that came with the machine in between the heater and the heat block. This will help to efficiently transfer heat between the two. Now, once you have everything put back together, you can go ahead and slide the new hot end in, go ahead and put those two screws back, and then put the silicone sleeve back on. Then you're done. I mean, again, this is a quick and easy fix. Now, before we get started testing the machine after our fix, I want to go ahead and thank everybody who responded to my original video, everybody who watched my original video. I really appreciate you all. Got some really helpful tips in there, and it's just generally really cool to see the community engaging with stuff that I put out there. So thank you so much. And I want to respond in particular to a few comments. I'm not always going to do this. I'm not always going to respond to every comment, but I promise I will read all of them and you can hold me to that. Huge shout out to Baron Lucas Vanderveide for calling it from afar. He was absolutely right. My nozzle was very low and it had come apart. So really good call there. I have contacted Sovol and they got back to me. They said that they would be sending me a new nozzle. I'll ask about the bed as well. For anybody who hasn't seen it yet, Baron Lucas Vanderveide has a pretty dope channel where it looks like he does a lot of really cool stuff with CNC machines. So if you haven't had a chance yet, go ahead and check that out. His channel is linked in the description. I saw this comment next from, looks like Rodrigo. I'm not totally sure how Z offset would impact the printer's ability to home or to detect the build plate in the first place, but I don't think it would. I appreciate the feedback though, super helpful. In the meantime, the cable on the back was something I acknowledged, but it wasn't a super high priority for me, but it doesn't look like you're the only one who's interested, so I'm here to please my audience. I don't know, I'm here for my viewers. If you guys want to see that fixed, then I guess we've got to fix it. But I'm telling you what, I'm not doing it with zip ties. I refuse. This is a 3D printing channel. We're going to 3D print something. And especially, there are so many people who have put so much work into making really cool stuff. This is a Voron clone. Let's make a Voron part. We've got these beautiful, well-designed clips made specifically for a Voron by Will. Thank you, Will. Really appreciate that. I love your design. I'm going to go ahead and throw it on my bed here. We're going to center it. Four walls. 400. I don't care. Who cares? Infill density. Let's go 99%. Let's split this out. I want 7 of them. We haven't tested the SV08 yet, so let's go ahead and print this out on my K1. This is the K1 using the Unicorn hot end, which is to say the hot end that ships with the K1C. I wasn't able to get a single hot end with the K1 working other than this one. So I'm really happy that they finally came out with one, but I'm sad that I spent almost the price of the printer on new hot ends just trying to get this one machine to work. And as somebody who was in the original pre-order, I'm fairly frustrated with Creality. I'm going to do another video on that later. But since we're killing time, I figured I'd go ahead and throw that in there. Preview for what's coming up. I also picked up a third-party motion system for the K1, which I will be testing as well once I receive that. So, more to look forward to. Stay tuned. Let's go ahead and get these installed. Again, Will did great in designing these clips. They go right onto the PTFE tube. And once you have them where you want them, this version of the clip clips right onto the electrical cable so that it's really easy to attach, and you can remove it when you need to in order to make changes to the wiring. And then we're all set. Looks great, looks much cleaner, and I'm ready to print. And now you can see all four quarters of the gantry are leveling normally, so let's go ahead and throw the traditional benchy on there. Just going to use regular speed benchy settings because who cares, we're just testing the printer to make sure that it prints. Now, one thing that I noticed on the SV08 is no matter how many times you press that auto Z offset button, it's not going to set the auto Z offset well. So you are going to have to do some manual fiddling. And I know from testing this machine already that the Z offset should be about 0.26 with a PLA filament, which is what we're using right now for this test. And so now we can see, great, the machine's back to working. And I'm getting a benchy, you get the idea. Let's go ahead and cut this short. Next, just to make sure that the automatic bed leveling is working, given the issues that we've been having with detecting the build plate, I went ahead and ran a first layer test. This is just a big square. I made it 0.24 millimeters thick because that's my first layer height setting, but you can put it at whatever height makes sense for what you're doing. This just checks to see what the printer actually does as opposed to what the bed mesh looks like. Now the other piece you'll see here in this little time lapse is that the leveling is a little bit more involved for a full bed print than it is for something like a benchy. That's something I actually appreciate with the SV08 is that it has adaptive mesh built in, essentially, from stock. That's something that I thought was going to be a pain to add, and it really saves a lot of time during the print. So what we're seeing here is that the leveling seems to be working pretty well. I'm getting some artifacts. It's not totally perfect, but the printer is working, and I really can't complain about that. What I can complain about, and what I am going to complain about, is the fact that this really isn't something that I expected to be happening with a printer this advanced. There's the leveling test, there's what it looks like. I'm sure some of this is definitely finger smudges. I'm sure some of this is just grease, I need to clean my build plate. But we've been at this for a little while, so let's go ahead and move on to part three. The long-term fix. I think this is going to need to come from Sovol. Overall, on paper, the SV08 is a really cool printer. It has a top speed of 700 millimeters per second, top acceleration of 40,000 millimeters per second squared, and of course, we're going to do some experiments to see how much that matters. And I'm just really, really excited to be working with it, especially because I'm such a big fan of the Voron project to begin with. A printer loses a lot of utility for me, though, if it causes me to have to take extra steps in checking that it's not going to break, or if it's making me have to watch it so that it can't be left unattended. That's just really difficult for me and the way that my workflow works. So this seemed like a bit of a step backward as opposed to a step forward. And I don't think it would be as concerning but for how few Sovol SV08s there are. When I initially bought the machine, I paid for an additional 4 nozzles because I figured, you know what, I'm the type of guy that has bad luck and something's going to happen with the nozzle. So I'm glad I did that. But the problem is that I've now had the Sovol SV08 for over a month and I still haven't gotten those nozzles. I ordered some new ones just last week once I figured out what the problem was so that I'd have even more on hand. But of course I have to wait online for those as well, which is fair enough, but it means that there's some potential that I may just not be able to use my SV08.
If this issue happens again, because I just won't have any nozzles, which is unfortunate because it's a $700 or $800 machine, depending on which version you buy.
But if it were up to me, I would definitely put a lot of Sovol's resources toward getting more nozzles on hand as quickly as possible. More good quality, durable nozzles, just in case we see more of this. And setting aside my own experience and my own costs going into this machine, because really, realistically, I can just use one of my other printers, that might not be an option for a lot of people. And for a lot of people, $800 is a really big investment. So I just want to see a path forward where it can pay off for them. Assuming that this isn't a widespread issue and maybe I just got a nozzle from a bad batch, then that might be as easy as just sending them something new. But if it's not, then we might be talking a lot of downtime for these printers, where a nozzle breaks, then they have to order new ones. Then the nozzle breaks again, then they've got RMA again, then the nozzle breaks again. And going back and forth with some of these 3D printer companies, especially the larger ones, it can take a day or two just to get a response asking you for more information. So it's just a lot of time. And time is money. I hear that I'm an early adopter. Somebody left a comment on that last video about how it's better to wait for these printers to be tested by other people. But like, that's not what I'm here for. That's not what type of channel this is. And that's also not how products work. When you sell a product, especially if you're not even a Kickstarter. Sovol, you're an established company. If you're selling a product, then the product should be at least good enough that it doesn't destroy itself under normal conditions. It should be at least good enough that it's not going to destroy my stuff that I add under normal conditions. And that is not, like, we are not beta testers. We paid for something that has already been tested. And so to basically scapegoat us and say that, well, you shouldn't have bought early, just doesn't seem right. We wouldn't do that with any other product. If your TV showed up and suddenly the screen just stopped working, you wouldn't say, oh, well, it's a new model television. No, the new model television should work better than the old. That's why they create the new one. This is the advancement of technology, people. And we can't just, like, shrug our way around it. What I really wanted from the Sovol SV08 was a great printer that prints like a Voron.
So far, it really, really has. But the nozzle just falling out.
And it's certainly possible, again, that the nozzle that I received was from a bad batch. But in any case, I think it would be good for Sovol to consider taking a look at its nozzles, taking another look at the testing that it's doing to make sure that everything is put together right, that it's all going to stay together, just to make sure that there's nothing that can be improved. Because I really don't trust this printer right now, and I want to see if there's a way that I can trust it moving forward. Also, Sovol, if you're listening, please add EddyProbe compatibility. If you like this video, go ahead and leave a like below. Helps us in the algorithm. If you are interested in learning more about 3D printing or are interested in seeing more videos like this, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. I'm going to be trying to do a new video every week or so. If you have any feedback or if there's anything that I can do to improve the quality of my videos or just if you want to leave some positive vibes, feel free to comment below. I'm really looking forward to working with you all. Thanks so much.